out to you.
No, let's you just gotta find that Wi-Fi.
Yeah. Or as the cool kids say it out there in Coachella, you gotta find the plug, right? But anyways, let's go out into Megafox versus Afro Smash.
That's something else.
I try to keep it PG, man. Try to keep it PG. Anyways, Afro Smash, man, a bit of a legend in the Twitterverse, finally making an IRL appearance. A lot of people have been wondering, what does Afro Smash look like? Ladies and gentlemen, Afro Smash out here in the flesh. And not only does he make it out here in the flesh, he's been making out here in pools. Out here to make sure he also represents the character as well in winner's side quarters. Of course, if he does manage to beat up Megafox, he does have to worry about who ESAM might be fighting against.
Yeah, so that's ESAM and the player. Actually, ESAM's going to have a very interesting road just because...
Yeah.
Oh, he's going to have to play Twerkmaster, the Game & Watch.
Yep. Twerkmaster just beat Ike Tyson as we were talking. So either Afro Smash will be fighting ESAM, Twerkmaster, Megafox, Afro Smash could be fighting themselves here in winner's semis of the bracket.
That is going to be moving top 128. Dang.
Yep.
That's just how you know there's so many people here, even in pools. Such top-class talents, high-level players coming in, battling it out just to stay on the winner's side.
Yep. And, of course, top 128 will take place tomorrow, day two of Prime Saga. But if you want to keep up with Prime Saga, of course, you already know the plug. smash.gg/Prime Saga to keep up with the bracket as it goes live. It is live now. Each pool are taking at different time places. This is the 2 o'clock pools. There are 4 o'clock pools, and so on and so forth.
We're going all the way up to 8 o'clock.
Yeah, man. We have a late nights out here. But, of course, as I said, we have late nights. We have a great artist out. We have a Kai Riot out here. For those of you guys wondering, if you're in the area and want to show up, we have a Kai Riot here with Spiff alongside, just to name a few of those players. Let's go into the match. Afro Smash versus Megafox.
Afro immediately trying to go for that upbeat out of shield, but Megafox just, you know, running away from it. But here we have Fox putting on all this pressure, all this percent. All you need is a couple of dash attacks and a couple of nairs to make some things happen. Back at the ledge, down tilt, trying to go ahead and creep under, poke a shield possibly. But Afro Smash just has been unable to get a word into this conversation so far.
Struggling out here, but that's one of the things about Fox, right? He's a zone breaker. He's able to immediately break in any zoning you're going for. And immediately, Megafox knows if I give him the time of day here, and this is right now, if I give him the zoning, he's going to get comfortable, and I don't want to have that. Parry, and he tries to go for an option, but that up air landing here is a multi-hit.
Yeah, I think Sonic Fox. Megafox was expecting a neutraler there instead of that falling up air.
I'm with you on that one, man. I wish Zero would play Sonic Fox, but all I got was a yeet. Anyways, let's go into it.
It's not happening.
Damn, it's not happening. The biggest lie ever told on Twitter, but let's go into it. What's possibly the truth here is Afro is starting to make a slow comeback.
They're not quite going to find the mark, but that up smash calling and catching the back air attempt from Afro Smash. Crossing up the shield, getting the grab, and you're in a world of hurt now. All these up airs, all these neutral airs. Afro sitting at 159 now, actually.
Oh, tries to check the shield there with the jab to the forward smash, but not getting anything out of that one. Afro Smash immediately looking for space here, and Megafox knows, okay? Let him have some time here for comfort. I'll wait for the opportunity to come in, but there's the forward air from Afro, finally getting the stock. 82% to his name here, retreats to the ledge. We saw how quick play that out at the ledge.
Honestly, this matchup just like looks like such a challenge for Samus to really get anything going. Afro hasn't been able to set up any type of missiles, any morph balls, or anything of the sort just like that. Megafox immediately just on him, coming in with these neutral airs, these back airs, stealing up stocks, and just interrupting anything he wants. Dash attack? Ooh, no. I thought we were going to see a Fox one, but no, Afro able to get one himself. Shield grab, actually able to get that dash attack. You know, it's very tricky to go ahead and try to punish dash attacks just because they're a fast character. A lot of them end up crossing up on shield.
Exactly. And you have to be wary once you get crossed up, because most players have the tendency to either be going for a parry or let go of shield. And once you go for those options and your opponent has crossed you up, you will take damage and you'll be opened up.
I mean, a lot of times when that situation happens, your opponent's behind you, you might want to go for a neutral or some type of aerial, but depending on what character you are, you can't do that. And you just have to reset the neutral instead. In the meantime, Afro Smash still trying to find an answer to get back onto the stage. Megafox keeping it up, getting that up air, almost stealing it out. Oh my goodness, trying to find that up smash, but gonna eat a forward smash himself. Down tilt, setting him up into the air and up air into that forwarder. Beautiful stuff from Afro right now, trying to look for a down air as well.
It's the back air.
This is all he needed.
It was really all he needed, and Megafox understood that. Went for the shine, tries to play it safe, especially. Afro Smash looking to slowly come back. He sets up the missile and I like it because he wants Megafox to hold shield or commit to a shine, but he'll only commit to the back air and the next game that's going to be in his favor.
Yeah, able to cast the jump there at the very end, but I love the adaptation from Afro Smash there on his very last stock. And you know what? Able to really understand exactly what Megafox is going for and how to punish a lot of the options that he was doing. It's because Megafox in the early going is just steamrolling him.
Exactly, and we talked about it earlier, right? Fox is able to zone break. Not only that, the burst options he has in terms of damage, tremendous. He's able to go ahead and put that to good use. Let's go into the next game. Afro up 1-0. Sorry, Megafox up 1-0. But I know the chat is interested to see if Afro Smash can take a victory here. Let's see what goes down here in Town and City.
All right, Zare leading into that grab. My man's put up shield immediately. Basically, even percents after that jab combo. Another one for your troubles, and that's something that you always got to be expecting when you're going against Fox. They get a neutraler, they're probably jabbing right after. Maybe an up tilt, you never know.
All right, Afro Smash immediately content to get back on the stage. He enjoys the fact that Megafox going to stay on the platform, close for an up air. Back throw, stage control, edge guard opportunity here, sets up the bomb ball, but no setup that how Megafox is going to fall into.
He ends up getting the spike, but nothing else after it. Tries to lead in with that back air for the air dodge, helping him out so much. And I love that from Megafox. Just running out of it. He just poked the shield real quick. He's like, all right, I don't want to get upbeat out of shield because Afro Smash has already shown that, you know, that is an option that you can go ahead and toss out.
Yep, there's the up tilt. Afro looking to see how Megafox is going to land. Possibly could have been going for a shine spark.
Water going to be safe, fading away from the shield. From his opponent.
Bomb ball, there you go. Tries to stall his recovery, still eats the up air, has to retreat towards the ledge to make safe passage here, and Megafox not gonna let this man live much longer, but Afro sneaks his way back.
And he's in a really good spot right now. Up smash again, not getting the kill, shielded, and a forward smash going to hit Megafox, and that's actually what happened in the first game. He went for one of those very greedy up smashes, got shielded, and ate a forward smash for his troubles. Ooh, I like that. Megafox trying to call it a jump. Not quite going to get it, and that shield is getting destroyed.
And that allows Afro to apply a little bit of pressure, go in, missing the grab here, and Megafox closes out the stock. Could have been a missed input with that upbeat, but Megafox takes advantage over here and gets the stage to himself, looking for a possible edge guard, and Afro gets the combo breaker with the upbeat.
And that's something that characters that have an upbeat out of shield that is very effective, they can immediately see anything that is not safe on shield, hit him with it. I mean, it's quite popular when you have a Chrom or a Cloud with their moves like that as well. Jumping right over that grab immediately, going for the forwarder as well. Megafox again, keeping up pressure, getting a lot of percent. The upper going to catch Afro Smash, trying to look for another one, but using the Morph Ball to mix up where he's going to be landing.
Megafox chasing him out there, and he pays for it. Gets the payoff.
I love
on that.
The forwarder was just in his face, barely didn't connect, and Afro was like, I don't know what to hit, and he just jumped immediately for that neutraler to get the stock.
Megafox knows, I don't want this man to have a second on the stage, and if we can definitely put that into work, Afro will have a tough time.
Afro just though? Chilling here at the ledge. He was like, you know, I'm not moving forward, please.
Yeah. All right, he's able to roll back on the stage, trying to get 5% of stage here. But cross-up coming up from Megafox. Afro just looking for the spacing. There's the point blank charge shot there. Doesn't buy him much, but the neutral air here. And finally, even stocks, but the percents are in Megafox's favor here. Puts him at the ledge here.
Park balls.
Up tilt to up air.
He's just not quite catching him this time around. Fox again, keeping the neutral layers, wants him to just stay on this ledge, and it's so hard to get off of it when you're going against the Fox.
And you can even see that Megafox kind of understands the space he should be, just in case Samus might be coming up from a Zare from the ledge, because he knows what that possibility might be holding for Afro Smash.
Down tilt into that up air, and exactly to your point, Megafox just understands the range in which Samus can or can't be at, and really, what allows Fox to exploit that?
Alright, Megafox checking himself here. Doesn't want to come up too
That's
short.
That's dangerous! Short,
and he got full face into that one, but he still survives with great DI. And the up smash from the punishment from the forward smash against Afro. That's going to be with a 20 and a sad handshake. Returning to
base. Just barely off the mark there. Very unfortunate for Afro Smash, but hey, Megafox just running through this bracket looking so clean.